Many of you have saw the rally from last week. Scott Lobato threw the rally. Frank was the MC. He lit it up. I went in there and, you know, did a little throwdown on Mayor de Blasio and Governor Cuomo and the teachers union, and I rambled on for a long, long time. And I've been working hard with the team to try to get our social media more exciting. And we're doing a really good job over the last month or so, 2 months at least. To the rescue comes my friend Frank, who's going to also start helping us, Frankie Gargano, one of the finest golf pros around. I often wear his gear, because you can check out his golf shop for tips and tricks at a trade at shotshavergolf.shop or shotshavershop.com. And also, Frankie and Mike are partners in a company called Hunter Marketing, where they help businesses and people grow their social media, make the stuff a little more compatible for how people like to watch stuff on social media. So we're going to be teaming up with Hunter Marketing right here. And if you want some help with your social media when you see how great these kids are doing with my team, reach out to me anytime. I'll put you in touch with them. But they took my whole rambling 10 minutes of fire and fury and zipped it down to a little clip that kind of tells the whole story on one of my topics, NYPD. Take a look how great this is.
I'm wearing this hat not because I want to kick on the cops, because my father was a proud member of the NYPD for 20 years. I wear it everywhere. There used to be a time when you would be proud to wear this. Now my kids say, "Dad, aren't you scared wearing that NYPD hat?" I said, "No. Our cops, they fight the men and women of the NYPD every single day to keep this city proud. But the guy who works in there has made this city nothing but a piece of..."
Hey, I mean, that's how it's going. Mikey, Frankie, ta-da. Thank you very much. Great job. And hopefully they'll be working with our team and doing a lot more so you can enjoy little bite-sized snippets of the best stuff you see here every day. And we got a lot of stuff going on, a lot of products and stuff that we're going to start introducing very soon. If we don't get some law and order in this country, we're going to have some major, major problems. And at the same time, the squad and the progressive left and all the blue cities with blue mayors are pandering to the progressive left. Defund the police, complete outward acts against the cops. Take a look what's happening in Minneapolis, and you tell me if this is the society that we know and love and we grew up in. Look what happened to this cop in Minneapolis. Show it again, Nico. It's one of those big metal tops from a garbage can in the street, like heavy, probably about 20, 30 pounds. They whipped it. Look. Bang. I don't know if you saw it, but the thing hit him square in the back of the head. His head smashed into the window of the car and went down unconscious. That's what our cops are being treated like in the streets right now. Donald Trump is saying, "I want to send in the National Guard." All the governor has to do is say the word and we'll be in there in a minute. But these blue governors and blue mayors don't want to do a thing. And at the same time, Joe Biden and Kamala Harris, they say nothing. They don't condemn the behavior. They don't come out and ask for it to stop. All they do is sit there and silently, by default, they basically say, "We're with you. Otherwise, we'd be doing something about it." Joe Biden's been around for 47 years. He's quite an important guy at this point. If that's his crowd, wouldn't he come out and say, "Hey, guys, let's stop this. We got to have some respect for our cops. We'll get the bad ones, but we got to have some respect for the 99.9% of the good ones. Otherwise, we're in a lawless society." And that's why I wear my NYPD hat all the time, because people are even afraid to show they support NYPD or their local police department, because you don't want to get attacked. Just like other people don't want to admit that they support Donald Trump when these bogus polls go around because they don't want to get attacked. And in some places, like campuses and schools and other places where there's so many liberals around, I know people that work for the teachers' union, that work inside of government administrations right now, that are progressive, who are big Trump supporters, but they can't tell their friends. So they have to be closet Trump supporters because they don't want to be scorned, even in social circles. So the silent majority needs to keep speaking up. I'm trying every day. We're bringing you the best guests who have no problem throwing it out there. But the cops shouldn't be getting smashed off the head with big hunks of metal, that's for sure. And Chris Christie, a former prosecutor himself and former governor of New Jersey, he weighed in on the Biden possibility of presidency. Take a look at what Chris Christie had to say with this jerk, Stephen Colbert.
You know, there were people further to the left than Joe Biden, like everybody else.
Except now Joe Biden has signed on with those left-wing principles to be able to get the nomination.
Maybe.
Himself. And so I understand he wanted to win the nomination. And I understand how you do that to try to win the nomination. But I think that the party has moved much too far left for me, Stephen. And what terrifies me is not Joe Biden himself, but Joe Biden in combination with the Democratic House and the Democratic Senate that I think could really hurt the country's economy and hurt the country's approach to the way we do business here.
There's Chris Christie. You know, he was known as kind of moderate guy. Even though he's a Republican, many used to say he was a rhino, but he's kind of moderate, right? He was a law and order man. He was a prosecutor, a U.S. federal prosecutor. And he said, I'm terrified of Joe Biden with a Democratic House and Senate. I'm terrified. I'm terrified for our economy, and I'm terrified for the new norms that we can expect with a lawless society that pays no respect to law and order and police and justice. And that's what we're seeing everywhere right now. Store owners are getting locked up for violating orders, but looters, rioters, and vandals are being set free. We're in bizarro world. But we'll be back right after this with Xen Sams and try to keep it real right here on